Good morning, everybody. I am Mallikarjun. I have come from Government Polytechnic Kottagudem, which is in Khammam District, Telangana State. Today, I would like to give you a brief introduction about the solidification process of metals. That is, how metals get solidified from the liquid state to the solid state. So, there is a peculiar behavior in all the liquids, how they get into solidification state. So this is a process of two stages, how the metals get solidified. So before that, we extract metals. During the extraction of metals, we extract metals from the solid state, and then in the furnace it converts into liquid, and from there again we carry that molten liquid through the ladles to the molds. So in the mold, how the metals are getting solidified. So there is two different aspects, that is a pure metal, how a pure metal gets solidified, and in the same in the other hand, how an alloy gets solidified. So there is two different ways of getting solidification process. So in general, how a metal or any other liquid gets solidification. So there are two stages. The first step is nucleation, formation of nucleation. So any metal which is in liquid state, first, a small embryo is formed or developed in the cold areas of the entire molten metal. So what is that? So as soon as I pour the molten metal into the mold, the walls will get immediate contact with this molten metal. So therefore, when we compare the temperature of the wall of the mold with the liquid, is very cold. That is, for example, if we take iron as a molten metal, the melting point of the iron is around 1539 degrees centigrade. So whereas the temperature of the mold will be a room temperature, if not room temperature, maybe a 50 degrees centigrade or 100 degrees centigrade. So when I compare this 1539 degrees centigrade with the mold temperature, that is, which is 100 degrees centigrade, definitely it is cold. So therefore, the moment the molten metal, which is having 1539 degrees centigrade, comes in contact with the mold wall, as I pour the molten metal into the mold cavity, so the immediate liquid which is in contact with the mold wall gets solidified first. It will try to start solidify first. So the liquid particle which is in immediate contact with the mold wall will try to get solidified. So the first step in that process is a nucleation. So the formation of nucleation is nothing but a small embryo is formed. Small globules are formed. So that's the size of the globule may be the size of an atom or maybe the size of a molecule, a few more atoms. So therefore, this nucleus, we call this embryo as a nucleus. So therefore, it is called as the formation of nucleation stage. So this nucleation tends to grow and it tries to accumulate the molten metal which is adjacent to that particular nucleus. So thus, it tends to grow and it tends to solidify the entire process. So the formation of nucleation and then the growth of the nucleation, and finally the entire metal gets solidified. If it is a pure metal, the solidification process takes at a single point, that is the melting point. If ever it is an alloy, then the solidification will be done in the range of some temperatures. Whereas it is impure, for example, the melting point of an iron is 1539 degrees centigrade. It will get solidified at 1539 degrees centigrade, just below the melting point of the metal. So whereas in the case of alloys, it will get, for example, I have a combination of iron, gold with copper. So the melting point of gold is around 1000 degrees centigrade, whereas copper is 1100 degrees centigrade. So the melting point of copper and gold will be at around 1100 to 1000 degrees centigrade or 900 degrees centigrade. So there will be a range for alloys, and in this range we call it as an intermediate phase. So this is a brief about the certification process of a pure metal and an alloy, and how a metal gets certified. Thank you.